Using the calculated data function in PyDataLink, you might have noticed an additional field for the conversion factor. It is a multiplier used to change a number from one unit of measure to another. Since the data archive is not aware of engineering units, it assumes that rate points are in terms of units per day. Typically, this assumption is inaccurate as many points are measured in terms of units per second, units per minute, or units per hour. When using the total function in calculated data, a conversion factor must be used to correct Pi's assumption that the data is in units per day. The conversion factor is equal to 1 when the source data are in units per day. To make it more clear, let's have a look at an example. We have a flow rate measured in liters per minute and stored in the data archive. We are interested in calculating total liters for an 8-hour period. As we can see in the illustration, the flow rate is 3 liters per minute for 3 minutes, then 5 liters per minute for 2 minutes, and 1 liter per minute for 3 minutes. Total flow is the area below the flow rate line, so the area of the three rectangles added up. The expected total flow would therefore be 22 liters. Data archive, however, assumes the unit of measure of flow rate is liters per day. Without applying the conversion factor, the total flow calculated by data archive is highly inaccurate. So to get the correct number, the total computed by the data archive must be multiplied by the conversion factor to get 22 liters. And don't worry, when making the conversions, you can use the conversion factor calculator. From the drop-down, we can make a selection based on the units of measure of the process variable. The required conversion factor number will be then calculated and placed in the conversion factor field. Let's practice what we have learned. We want to calculate the total flow and the average flow rate of mixing tank 1 for yesterday. To know what conversion factor to use, we need to bring the unit of measure of flow rate for mixing tank 1. Let's begin by creating a template in Excel. We need a field for the root path, data item, start time, end time, unit of measure, and finally, don't forget, the total conversion factor. Let's also add columns for average, total, and percent good. Let's now go to search and navigate to mixing tank 1 and find the flow rate attribute. Remember to set the slider to name only and click OK. For the start time, type Y, which translates to yesterday at midnight, and T for the end time, which translates to today at midnight. To get the unit of measure, go to Properties, select our data item, and choose unit of measure from the drop-down list and click OK. To find out what's the conversion factor we need to use, let's open up the calculated data function and use the conversion factor calculator. Now we know that our flow rate is in units per minute, so let's select it here to get the correct number. Now we can type it in into our template. Now we are ready to calculate the average, so let's go to the calculated data function, select our data item, root path, start time, end time, and the average for the calculation mode. Now let's calculate the total of flow rate for this time range. So again, choose the calculated data function. Now select our data item, root path, start and end time. Don't forget to select the conversion factor and also add the percent good. This concludes our video on calculating the total in PyDataLink. Thanks for watching!